women came up to Jesus, knelt down before him and say, Lord, have pity on my son, who is a lunatic and suffers severely. Often he falls into fire and often into water. I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him. Jesus said in reply, O faithless and perverse generation, how long will I be with you? How long will I endure you? Bring the boy here to me. Jesus rebuked him, and the demon came out of him. And from that hour, the boy was cured. Then the disciples approached Jesus in private and said, Why could we not drive it out? He said to them, Because of your little faith. Amen, I say to you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. The Gospel of the Lord. Of whom Jesus speaks when he says, faithless and perverse people, how long will I have to put up with them? Could it be the father of this child? I don't believe it. I don't believe it because he was a father concerned about his son. Any father would have moved heaven and earth to seek health for his son. Besides, he had prostrate himself before him on his knees. In other words, he had gone with humility and faith. So when they asked him, why were we not able to heal him? He answers then, in another way, he tells them, because of your little faith, you're faithless people, because of your little faith. Do we have faith? The saints had it. They had it. There is a miracle that they say that St. Martin of Porres of Lima did. I have read it, and I do not doubt his historicity. He gave so much alms and performed so many miracles that the prior of the convent had forbidden him to do more because there were always lines of people asking the saint to perform a miracle. On one occasion, he said that a construction worker was falling from a scaffolding and that he was probably going to be badly injured or die. And with his simplicity and kindness, he said, stay in the air. He went to ask permission from the prior of the convent, return, and then prevent the man from dying from the fall. People who had faith. I had the opportunity to be with St. John Paul II on many occasions. And what I saw was a man who had faith. Faith gave him courage. Faith with the natural condition that God gave him. He also gave him light. The Holy Spirit acted through him. He was a man who had faith, who truly believed. He was a man who believed in God, in the strength of God, in the power of God, in the existence of God, in eternal life. He was a man who had faith in the miracles he did. Not only the ones he did after his death, for which he was first beatified and then canonized, the miracles he continues to do, rather, the miracles that God works through his intercession, the miracles he performed during his lifetime. For example, he managed to bring down the Berlin Wall, and many European countries were able to enter into freedom. These miracles he performed because he had faith. Of course, he looked for allies. Of course, there was the President of the United States, who was a man with whom he got along very well, Reagan. But the important thing was that he had faith. Do we have faith? I have faith. When I pray, when I ask for someone, and I do it every day I entrust these people who have asked me to pray. I am sure that God hears me. he will do what he thinks he has to do, because that is what God is for. But I'm sure that God listens to me. I'm sure that God hears me, not because of my marriage, but because I'm sure that the Lord hears our prayers. Do you really believe that the Lord hears your prayer? And if you do not believe it, it is not your lack of faith that prevents this prayer from reaching God and having an effect. If we had faith, many mountains will disappear. In other words, many obstacles will be resolved. Let us trust in God. Let us have faith in Jesus. Amen.